Hello guys, welcome back to Tech Dose, and in this video I will talk about cut or control backtracking. So these characters denote the cities and the green line denotes the roads connecting these cities. This sky blue line is our river, okay, and we are at city A and suppose we want to reach at city I. So suppose I was filled in with an information that on my way to city I will see a river, okay. So this is on my brain, okay, and I will start from A. Let's say I reached B and there is two options. I moved left to C, then to D. Again, we had no option at D. We moved back to C. From C, we explored E. There is no other option from E. So we moved back to C. From C, we moved back to B. And from B, we moved to F. From F, again, we had two options, either to go left or right. Let's say we moved left, okay. Now we saw that a river was crossing this road, okay. So we were already filled with the information that we will see a river on my way to I. So here, this point, I will mark this point, okay, and will make it as a checkpoint, okay, and I will reach G. From G, I have two options, either to go left or right. Let's say I went to left and I reached H. This was not our goal, so I backtracked to G. Again, I moved to I and I found my goal, okay. And so our program succeeded. Let's say the goal was not at I, the goal was at K. So what we will do is, from I, we will again go back to G, and from G we have no other option, okay. And we have already made a checkpoint between F and G that I will see a river. So I saw a river and I created a checkpoint. Now I cannot go back from the checkpoint because I already know that I need to cross a river in order to reach my goal. So this information was wrong, okay. But we crossed the river and we are stuck here and we cannot go, and so we will report as false, or we were unable to find the goal, okay. So I hope this concept of cut was clear to you. Now we can have one cut or more than one cuts, okay. So let's say we extend this. From H we have two more cities, and let's say the city's name are A dash and B dash, okay. And let's say our goal is B dash, okay. And let's say we have a shop between H and A dash, and let's call it as S, and this is here on the roadside. Then we wanted to reach, say, B dash. What we will do from H is, I will move left, say I moved left, okay, and I was filled with the information that I will see a river, I will cross a river, and then I will see a shop. And this information was wrong, this information was wrong, and this was correct, okay, because we cannot just find out which informations are right unless we explore them. So let's say this shop information was wrong, and we saw a shop, and we created a checkpoint here as S, okay. And then we moved to A dash and then found that A dash was not our goal, and we cannot go back to H because we had already crossed the shop which we were told, okay. So because of this cut, we cannot go back. If there was no cut, then we would have moved to H, and then from H we would have explored B dash and would have sufficed our goal. But since we had created a checkpoint or a cut between H and A dash, so we cannot go back, okay. So in simple terms, what we can say that if we are given some expressions or functions, okay, and then we have a cut, and again we have some expression or functions, we can backtrack among these functions. Let's say A, B and C, we can backtrack among these functions as many times as the choices are available, okay. But once we cross this boundary, okay, then we cannot go back here. But we can always backtrack among these functions, whatever are present on the other side of the cut, okay. And there can be more than one cuts, like in this part. There was a cut created here, C1, the cut here, and again there was a cut S, okay, C2. So we can have as many cuts as you want. And what is the benefit of this cut? This cut tells the PROLOG system that it has found the right rule for a particular goal. Because here you can see that on seeing the river, we were told that we will see a river, and when we saw the river, then we found that we were on the right track. So it is like telling PROLOG system that it has found the right rule for a particular goal and it should continue this path and should not try the other paths ever. Okay. So this is the first use of PROLOG cut. The second use is, we don't want to produce multiple results using backtracking. Suppose we had two results, let's say at B dash and let's say at goal. Okay. And there was no cut here. Let's say C2 was not a cut. Okay. Then what would have been the case is that we would have moved to B dash, but since we had created a cut C1, we could not backtrack from G to F. If there was a cut C2 and our goal was A dash, then only A dash would have run, because this cut would have prevented us from backtracking from the city A dash to H. Okay. So this is the use of this cut. What is the benefit from cut? It saves a lot of processing power. So our computer is already processing all these things in their processor, so this will be saving a lot of processing power as well as processing time, and it will also save us the memory, that means RAM. Okay, because it has to work lesser due to the use of these cuts. It is just decreasing the domain. You can see that the entire domain was this entire figure. This figure was our domain, but since this cut was introduced, our domain decreased from the entire figure to this part, and again a cut was introduced and our domain decreased to further just one city, that means A dash. So you can see that our domain kept on decreasing, and this led to lower processing power requirement as well as lower RAM requirement. Okay, so let us see how can we write this. In simple terms, if we have say a predicate or a function foo, then for a single cut we can have as many number of functions or conditions from A1 to AK, and then suppose we are presented with a cut and then we have functions AK plus 1, AK plus 2, dot 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 to AN. Okay, then we can backtrack as many times as we like in this part. We can backtrack as many time as we like in this part. But once AK succeeds, once this succeeds, then it will cross the boundary and then we can never go back from this part to the first part. Okay, this cannot happen once AK succeeds. So this should be kept in mind. And we can create more number of cuts. Okay, suppose we also created a cut here, and again we have some functions, say B1, B2, dot 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 to say some BS. Okay, so we have created two boundaries. Likewise, we can create as many boundaries as we like. Okay, I hope you were able to understand the cuts. If you like this video, then please hit the like button, and if you have any special video request, then do comment below, and also your queries, I will try to help you as soon as possible. Please subscribe to our channel in order to watch more programming videos. See you in our next video. Thank you.